Thank you very much for coming to tonight's performance of the play I wrote. We all want you to enjoy this play, so please turn off and put away your mobile phones, because Siobhan says using them during a performance is very rude. And you can also use the toilet and buy a treat during the 10-minute intermission. Now, please enjoy my play, The Curious Incident of the Dog in the Nighttime.
£1.47. This was made up of a £1 coin. need my watch to know exactly what time it is.
You hear that?
Right, son, you keep it.
Do you have any family, Mr. Bell?
Yes, I do.
And who is your family?
Father and mother, but mother is dead. And also Uncle Terry, who lives in Sunderland. And my grandparents, too. But three of them are dead, and Grandma Bert is in a home because she has senile dementia and thinks I'm someone on television.
Right. Look. Do you know your father's phone number, Christopher?
I could see the Milky Way as they drove me towards the town center.
Could you?
Some people think our galaxy is a long line of stars, but it isn't. Our galaxy is a huge disk of stars, millions of light years across. And for a long time, scientists were puzzled at the fact that the sky is dark at night, even though there are billions of stars in the sky.
Is that right?
Christopher, Mr. Boone, would you come this way, please?
Are you going to interview me and record the interview?
No, I don't think there will be any need for that. I spoke to your father and he says that you did mean to hit the policeman. Did you mean to hit the policeman?
Yes.
But you didn't mean to hurt the policeman?
No, I didn't mean to hurt the policeman. I just wanted him to stop touching me.
You know that it's wrong to hit a policeman, don't you?
Yes.
Did you kill the dog, Christopher?
I did not kill the dog.
You know that it's wrong to lie to a policeman, and that you can get into a very great deal of trouble if you do.
I do.
Do you know who killed the dog?
No.
Are you telling the truth?
Yes. I always tell the truth.
Right. I'm going to give you a caution.
Is that going to be on a piece of paper, like a certificate I can keep?
No, a caution means that we're going to keep a record of what you did. That you killed a policeman, but that it was an accident.
But it wasn't an accident.
Christopher, please.
And if you get into any more trouble, we'll take out this record and see that you have been given a caution, and we'll take things much more seriously. Do you understand what I'm saying?
The second main reason I find people confusing is that people often talk using metaphors. These are examples of metaphors.
I'm seriously going to lose my marbles.
He was the apple of her eye.
They had a skeleton in the cupboard.
We have a real pig in the day.
The dog was stone dead.
The word metaphor means carrying something from one place to another, and it is when you describe something by using a word for something that it isn't. This means that the word metaphor is a metaphor.
Wow, that's clever.
It's true.
Yes. I think it should be called a lie because a pig is not like a day, and people do not have skeletons in their cupboards. And when I try and make a picture of the phrase in my head, it just confuses me, because imagining an apple in someone's eye doesn't have anything to do with the likeness of the lot, and it makes you forget what the person was talking about.
I'm sorry.
It's okay.
I didn't kill Wellington.
Christopher, you've got to try and stay out of trouble, okay?
I didn't know I was going to get into trouble. I like Wellington, and I went to go say hello to him. I didn't know that someone had killed him.
Just try and keep your nose on other people's business.
I'm going to try and find out who killed Wellington.
Were you listening to what I was just saying?
Yes, I was listening to what you were just saying, but when someone gets murdered, you have to find out who did it so they can be punished.
It's a bloody dog, Christopher. A bloody dog.
I think dogs are important too. I think some dogs are cleverer than some people. Nicholas, for example, who comes to school on Thursdays, needs help eating his food, and he probably couldn't even fetch a stick.
Leave it.
I wonder if the police will find out who killed Wellington and punish the person.
I said leave it! For God's sake!
Thank you. Very well, sir.
Mother died 2 years ago. I came home from school one day, and no one answered the door. So, I went and found a secret key that we keep hidden under a flower pot outside the kitchen window. I let myself into the house and wiped my feet on the mat. I put the key in the bowl on the table. I took my coat off and hung it by the side of the fridge so I'd be ready for school the next day. And I gave 3 pellets of rat food to Toby, my pet rat. I made myself a raspberry milkshake and heated it up in the microwave. Then, I went up to my bedroom and played 6 games of Tetris. And I got to level 38, which is my 4th ever score. An hour later, Father came home from work.
Christopher, have you seen your mum?
No.
He went downstairs and started making some phone calls. I did not hear what he said. Then he came up to my bedroom and said he had to go out for a while, and he wasn't sure how long he would be. He said that if I needed anything, I should call him on his mobile phone. He was away for 2.5 hours. When he came home, I went downstairs.
I'm afraid you won't be seeing your mother for a while.
Why not?
She's had to go into hospital.
Can we visit her?
No.
Why can't we?
She needs to be on her own. She needs rest.
Is it a psychiatric hospital?
No, it's an ordinary hospital. Christopher, listen. She's a problem. A problem with her heart.
I'll make her a get well card. If I make her a get well card, will you bring it in for her tomorrow?
How are you today, Christopher?
I'm very well, thank you.
That's good.
In the bus on the way to school, we passed 4 red cars in a row. Yes, so today is a good day.
That's great, I'm glad.
I've decided I'm going to try and find out who killed Wellington, because a good day is a day for projects and planning things.
Who's Wellington?
Wellington is a dog who used to belong to Mrs. Shears, but is dead now because someone killed him by putting a garden wall through him. And I found him, and then a policeman thought I killed him, but I hadn't, and then the policeman tried to touch me, so I hit him, and then he had to go to the police station.
Gosh.
And I'm going to find out who killed him and make it a project. Even though Father told me not to.
Did he?
Yes.
I see.
I don't always do as I'm told.
Why?
Because when people tell you what to do, it is usually confusing and does not make sense. For example, people often say, be quiet, but they never tell you how long to be quiet for.
No. Why did your father tell him not to try to find out who killed Wellington?
I don't know.
Well, if your father's told you not to do something, maybe you shouldn't do it. We're meant to be writing stories today, so why don't you write about the town of Wellington?
Okay, I will.
Christopher, I'm sorry. Your mother's died. She had a heart attack. It wasn't expected.
What kind of heart attack?
Christopher, I don't know what type of heart attack. Now isn't the time to be asking those types of questions.
probably an aneurysm.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm really sorry.
That evening, I went round to Mrs. Shear's house and knocked on the door and waited for her to answer it.
What are you doing here?
I wanted to come and tell you that I didn't kill Wellington and that I'm going to try and find out who did kill him.
No, I'm not sure I really want to see you right now, Christopher.
Do you know who killed Wellington?
If you don't go now, I will call the police again.
Reverend Peters, where is heaven?
I am sorry, Christopher.
In our universe, whereabouts is it exactly?
It's not in our universe. It's another kind of place altogether.
There isn't anything outside our universe, Reverend Peters. There isn't any other kind of place altogether. Except there might be if you go through a black hole. But a black hole is what is called a singularity, which means it's impossible to find out what is on the other side, because the gravity of a black hole is so big that even electromagnetic waves like light can't escape it, and electromagnetic waves are how we get information about things which are far away from us. And if heaven was on the other side of a black hole, dead people would have to be fired into space on a rocket to get there, and they aren't, or people would notice.
Well, when I say heaven is outside our universe, it's really just a matter of speaking. I suppose what it really means is that there is God.
But where is God?
Christopher, we should talk about this on another day, when I have more time.
The next day was Saturday, and there's not much to do on Saturday unless Father takes me out somewhere on an outing, to the boating lake or to the garden center. But on this Saturday, England were playing Romania at football, which meant that Father wanted to stay home and watch the telly. So I made a decision. I decided to do some more detection. I decided to go out on my own. I do not like strangers, so talking to other people on our street is great. But if you're going to do detective work, you have to be brave. So I had no choice.
Thank you.
someone must know who killed Wellington, because the person who killed Wellington knows they killed Wellington. Unless they were a looming person, or unless they had amnesia.
Right, well, you're Christopher, aren't you?
Yes, I live at number 36.
I don't believe we've spoken before, have we?
No, I don't talk to strangers, but I'm doing detective work.
Well, I see you going to school every day on the school bus, and I have one in my book. It is very nice of you to come and say hello, but this is only because you are doing detective work.
Thank you.
I have a grandson your age.
My age is 15 years, 3 months, and 3 days.
Well, oh, what's your age then? You don't have a dog, do you?
No.
I bet you'd like a dog then, wouldn't you?
I have a rat.
Rat?
He's called Toad. Most people don't like rats because they think they carry strange diseases like chronic plague, but that's only because they're stowed away on ships coming from foreign countries where there were strange diseases, but rats are very clean.
All right, well, would you like to come in for tea?
No. I don't go into other people's houses.
Oh, well, perhaps I could bring tea out here then. Do you mind if I bring it?
Orange. I only like orange.
Well, luckily, I have got some back as well. And how about some back though?
I don't know whether I would like back though, because I do not know what back is.
Oh, well, it's a sort of cake. It has marzipan icing around the walls.
Is it a long cake with a square cross section that can be equally divided into alternately colored and equally spaced squares?
Yes, I think you can describe it that way.
Then I think I would like the pink squares, but not the yellow squares, because I do not like yellow. And I don't know what marzipan is, so I don't know whether I would like that either.
I'm afraid marzipan is yellow as well, so perhaps I should just give some cookies. You do like cookies, don't you?
Some sort of cookies.
All right then, I will get a selection. She moved very slowly because she was an old lady, and she was inside the house for more than 6 minutes. Now I began to get nervous because I didn't know what was whether she was telling the truth about getting orange shaped and back in her cake. And I began to think that she might be bringing the police, and then I'd get into much more serious trouble because of the caution. So I walked away.
Yeah!
Crap.
enough deal from you already, without you crapping on him from this great height as well. I mean, this is something that he's really, really good at.
Maybe we should talk about this later, on our own.
Are there things you're too embarrassed to say in front of Christopher?
No, it's not that.
Say it now, then.
If Christopher takes the test now, he would need a member of staff, a supervisor, there in the room with him when he takes them.
I'll pay for it. We can do it after school. Here, 50 quid, is that enough?
Mr. Boone.
I'm not taking no for an answer.
If I could bring Toby with me to space.
So the book is finished.
Well, Christopher, if your father's told you to stop, then I think you should stop because I'm sure he probably has a good reason for you to. But you can still be very proud of what you've written so far because it's amazing.
It isn't a proper book.
Why not?
Because it doesn't have a proper ending. I never found out who killed Wellington, so the murderer is still at large.
And not all murders are solved and not all murderers are caught.
Father said that Mr. Shears was an evil man and that I was never to mention his name in our house again. Do you know why he said that?
I think you should do what your father tells you. Christopher, what happened to you the other day? I came back out here and you'd gone. I had to eat all of those biscuits by myself. I was looking forward to our little chat, you know.
I don't do chatting. I don't like it.
Oh, yeah, no, I don't suppose you do. Do you like computers, though?
Yes, I have a computer in my room.
I know, I can see you sitting at your computer in your room sometimes when I look across the street.
And I like maths and outer space and taking care of Toby, my pet rat.
I bet you're very good at maths, aren't you?
Yes, I'm going to be taking A-levels next semester and I'm going to get an A-star.
Really? A-level maths?
Yes, I'm the first person in my school to be taking A-levels because everyone else in my school is stupid. Except I'm not meant to call them that, even though it is what they are.
All right, well, I am very impressed, and I hope you do get an A-star.
I will.
Okay, well, the only other thing I know about you is that your favorite color is not yellow.
No, and it's not brown either. My favorite colors are red and metal color. Do you know anything about Mr. Shears?
Not really. I mean, I knew him well enough to say hello, but I didn't really know anything about him. I think he works at the National Westminster Bank in town.
Father said that he was an evil man. Do you know why he said that?
Perhaps it would be best not to talk about these things, Christopher.
Why?
Well, because perhaps your father's right, and you shouldn't go around asking questions about it.
Why not?
Well, because obviously he's going to find it very upsetting.
Why is he going to find it very upsetting?
Okay, look. Christopher, I think you might know why your father doesn't like Mr. Shears very much.
Did Mr. Shears kill Mother?
What?
Did he kill her?
Good gracious, Christopher, no, of course he didn't kill your mother.
But he did give her stress so that she died of a heart attack.
I honestly don't know what you're talking about.
Or did he hurt her so that she had to go into hospital?
Did she have to go to hospital?
Yes. It wasn't very serious at first, but then she had a heart attack.
Oh my goodness.
And died.
Oh my goodness, I'm so sorry, I never realized.
Why did you say, I think you know why your father doesn't like Mr. Shears very much?
Perhaps you and I should take a walk in the park together. This isn't really the sort of place to be talking about these kinds of things. Okay, Christopher, I'm going to tell you something. You must promise not to tell your father that I told you this, okay?
Why?
Please just trust me.
Okay, I promise.
All right. So, your mother, before she died, was very good friends with Mr. Shears.
I know.
No, Christopher, I don't think you did. I mean to say that they were, you know, very, very good friends.
Do you mean they were doing sex?
Yes, Christopher, that's what I mean. Okay. Christopher, I'm really sorry. I didn't mean to say anything that would upset you, but...
Is that why Mr. Shears left Mrs. Shears? Because he was doing sex with someone else while still being married to Mrs. Shears?
Yes, I expect so.
I think I should go now.
Are you going to be okay, Mr.?
I can't be on my own with you because you're a stranger.
I'm not really a stranger, Christopher. I am a friend. Have you told your father about this?
No.
Are you going to tell your father about this?
No.
Did it make you sad to find this out?
To find what out?
Did it make you sad to find out that your mother was having an affair with Mr. Shields?
No.
Are you telling the truth?
Yes, I always tell the truth. It did make me feel sad because mother is dead. So I would be feeling sad about something that isn't real and doesn't exist, and that would be stupid.
What was your mother like? Do you remember much about her?
I remember the 20th of July, 2008. It was a Sunday. We were on holiday in Portugal. I was 9 years old. We were on the beach in a place called Polpera, and mother wasn't swimming. She was sunbathing on a red and purple striped towel, and she was reading a book called The Masqueraders. And when she was finished sunbathing, she stood up and went into the water a little way and said,
"Bloody Nora is cold."
"Bloody Nora, it's cold." And then she said I should come into the water a little way and join her. But I don't like swimming because I don't like taking my clothes off. And she said I should just roll up my trousers and come into the water a little way. So I did. And mother said,
"Christopher, look, it's lovely."
And then she jumped backwards and disappeared under the water. And I thought sharks had eaten her, so I screamed. And then she stood up out of the water and came over to where I was standing. And she raised her right hand and spread her fingers out like a fan.
"Come on, Christopher. Touch my hand. Come on now. No, stop screaming. Touch my hand. Listen to me, Christopher. You can do it. It's okay, Christopher, it's okay. There are no sharks in Cornwall."
When we were inside the park, Miss Alexander stopped walking and said, "I'm going to say something to you, and you must promise not to tell your father that I told you this. Your mother, before she died, was very good friends with Mr. Shields.
And other times, mother used to say,
if I hadn't married your father, I think I'd be living in a little farmhouse on the south of France with someone called Jean. And he'd be a local handyman. You know, doing painting and decorating for people, gardening, building fences. You'd have a French bulldog and a veranda with pigs growing over it. And there would be sunflowers growing at the bottom of the garden. And a little town on a hill in the distance. And we'd sit outside in the evening and drink red wine and smoke French cigarettes and watch the sun go down."
"What is this?"
"It's a book. I'm writing."
"Is it true? Did you speak to Mrs. Alexander?"
"Yes."
"Oh, Christopher, how stupid are you? What did I tell you, Christopher?"
"You told me to never mention Mr. Shears' name in our house again. To not go asking Mrs. Shears or anyone who killed that bloody dog. To stop trespassing on other people's gardens. And to stop this bloody ridiculous detective game. Except I haven't done any of those things. I was just talking to Mrs. Alexander because we were doing chatting."
"Don't give me that bollocks. You knew exactly what you were doing. I read the bloody book, remember? What else did I say to you, Christopher?"
"I
don't know.
Come on, memory man. Not till you're sticking your nose into other people's business. And what do you do? You go around and you stick your nose into everyone else's business. You go around to dig up the past and share it with every Tom, Dick, and Harry you bump into. What am I going to do with you, Christopher? What am I going to do?
I wasn't doing investigating. I was just talking to Mrs. Alexander.
I asked you to do one thing for me, Christopher. One thing.
I didn't want to talk to Mrs. Alexander. It was Mrs. Alexander who wanted to talk to...
I need a drink. I'm sorry I hit you. I didn't mean to. Christopher, I love you very much. Don't ever forget that. I just hate to see you getting into trouble. I don't want to see you get hurt.
Where's my book?
Christopher, you do understand that I love you.
Lots of hair in it, a monkey wrench, a chocolate chip cookie, and a magazine called Men Only, and a pair of underpants from TJ Maxx with a little bit of pee left in them, and a Scooby-Doo tie and a wooden spoon, but not my problem. Then I looked in the drawers on either side of the dressing room. But these only contained aspirin, nail fillers, batteries, dental floss, tissues, and a spare false tooth and a tampon. But my book wasn't there either. Then I looked in his wardrobe.
But I still love you.
so?
Yes.
Give me a coat. Hang it up. How was school?
It was good, thank you. Joseph Fleming took his trousers off and went to the toilet all over the floor of the chamber. And then he started to eat it.
Did he?
Yes, but Mr. Davis stopped him.
Oh, good old Mr. Davis.
Joseph eats everything. He once ate a 50-pound note from his mother's wallet, and he bangs his chin and he screams a lot.
Yeah, Christopher, I know how he feels. Christopher, I've got to go on.
Why?
A lady's called. The cellar's flooded. Got to go out and fix it.
Is it an emergency?
Yes, mate.
It is raining very heavily.
It is.
The rain looks like white sparks.
Christopher, you're going to be okay if I go out?
Yes, I will, because there's nobody back, because everyone is staying indoors.
Good, good. Good lad.
I like looking at the rain.
Terrific.
I like it because it makes me think how all the water in the world is connected.
Does it?
Yes. This water, this rain, has evaporated from somewhere like the Gulf of Mexico, maybe, or Baffin Bay, and now it is falling in front of our house.
I'll have my mobile with me.
Yes.
So you can call me if you need anything.
Yes.
Be a good lad. Yeah?
Yeah.
So I went into his bedroom and opened up the wardrobe and lifted the toolbox off the top of the shirt box and opened the shirt box. I counted out the letters. There were 43 of them. They were all addressed to me in the same handwriting. I took one and opened it. Inside was this letter.
451C Chapter Road, Wilson, London, NW25MG, 02088878907. Dear Christopher, I said I wanted to try and explain to you why I went away when I had the time to do it properly. Now I have lots of time. So I'm sitting on the sofa here with this letter and the radio on, so I'm going to try and explain. I was not a very good mother, Christopher. Maybe if things had been different, maybe if you'd had been different, I might have been better at it. But that's just the way things turned out. I'm not like your father. Your father's a much more patient person. He just gets on with things, and if things upset him, he doesn't let it show. But that is not the way I am, and there's nothing I can do to change it. Do you remember once when we were shopping in town together, and we went into Bentalls, and it was really crowded, and we had to get a Christmas present for Grandma, and you were frightened because of all the people in the shop. And you crouched down on the floor and put your hands over your ears and you were in the way of everyone. And I got cross because I don't like shopping at Christmas either. And I tried to pick you up and move you, but you shouted and knocked those mixers off the shelf and there was a big crash. And everyone turned around to see what was going on, and there were boxes and bits of string and bits of broken bowl on the floor. Everyone was staring, and I saw what you had cut yourself. And I became so cross, I just wanted to take you out of the shop, but you wouldn't let me touch you, and we just had to wait until you stopped screaming. And I remember that night, I just cried and cried and cried. Your father was really nice about it at first. He made you supper, put you to bed, and he said, these things happen, and it would be okay. But I said I couldn't take it anymore, and eventually he got really cross and told me I was being stupid and should pull myself together, and so I hit him! Which was wrong. But I was so upset. We had a lot of arguments like that, Christopher, and eventually we stopped talking to each other very much because we knew it would always end up in an argument. and I felt really lonely.
And that was when I started spending lots of time with Roger.
And that was when I started spending lots of time with Roger. But I know you might not understand any of this, but I wanted to try and explain so that you knew.
We had a lot in common, and then we realized that we were in love.
Well, I said I couldn't leave you, and he was really sad about that. But he understood that you were really important to me.
And you started to shout, and I got thrown across, and I threw the food across the room, which I know I shouldn't have done.
And you grabbed the chopping board, and you threw it, and it hit my foot and broke my toes.
And afterwards, at home, your father and I had a huge argument.
And I couldn't walk properly for a month, do you remember? Your father had to look after you.
And I remember looking at the two of you and seeing you together and seeing how you were acting with him. You seemed much calmer.
And that made me so sad because he was like, you didn't need me at all.
And I think then I realized you and your father were probably better off if I wasn't living in the house.
And that's when Roger asked me if I wanted to come with him.
And I meant to say goodbye.
But when I rang your father, he said I couldn't. He was really angry. He said I couldn't.
He said I couldn't talk to you.
And I didn't know what to do.
He said I was being selfish and that I was never to set foot inside the house again.
So I haven't.
I wonder if you can understand any of this. I know it will be difficult for you.
I thought I was just doing what was best for everyone. I hope it still is.
Christopher, I never meant to hurt you.
You remember how you used to say that you wanted to be an astronaut? Well, I used to have dreams that you were an astronaut. And you were on television and I thought, that's my son. I wonder what it is that you want to be now. Has it changed? Are you still doing maths? I hope you are. Loads and loads of love. Mother.
An accident. I don't know what to say. I was in such a mess. I told you your mother was in hospital because I didn't know how to explain it. And once it said that, I couldn't just change it. Just look out of control. Oh, Christopher. You've gotten sick all over yourself. Come on. Let's get you up. Let's get those clothes off. Let's get you into bed. I'm gonna have to touch you. But it's gonna be okay.
Maybe I shouldn't tell you this. I want you to know that you can trust me. I mean, life is difficult. It's bloody hard telling the truth all the time. But I want you to know that I tried. I want you to be able to trust me about everything. Don't tell the truth now. It just hurts more later on. So Christopher, I killed Wellington. Just let me explain. When your mum left, I think Mrs. Shears. She was very good to me. Honestly, I don't think I would have made it without her. I mean, you know how she was. Drop around here most days. Seeing if we needed anything. Seeing if we were okay. I thought. I'm just trying to keep this simple, Christopher. I thought we were friends. I guess I thought wrong. We argued, Christopher. And she said some things to me that I'm not going to say to you because they were not very nice. They hurt me. I mean, sometimes I feel like more than she cared more for that bloody dog than she did for either of us. Maybe that's not so stupid looking back. I mean, it's a lot easier to spend your life looking after some stupid mutt than living with actual other real life human beings. I mean, buddy, we're not exactly low maintenance. Anyway, we had this fight. I mean, we had a lot of fights. But after this particularly nasty little blowout, she chucked me out of the house. And you know what that dog was like? Nicest pie one moment. Roll over, tickle its stomach. Sink its teeth into your leg and neck. So we're yelling in the kitchen, and it's in the garden. She slams the door behind me, and the bug is waiting for me. And I know, if I had just given it a kick, it probably would have backed off. But when the red mist comes down, you know what I mean. We're not that different, you and me. Everything I've been bottling up for the last 2 years, just... I promise, I never meant for it to turn out this way.
Come and live with your Uncle Terry.
Sunderland.
I don't know how to get to Sunderland.
Take the train. Take the train from Swindon.
You also stroke my hair and smoke cigarettes. You're not a friend either.
I think I'm a friend.
I can't stay overnight at your house and use your toilet because you've used it and you're a stranger.
I'm not really a stranger, Crystal.
Yes, you are!
45 Wednesday Chapter Road, London, NW2 5MD. 45 Wednesday Chapter Road, London, NW2 5MD. 45 Wednesday Chapter Road, London, NW2 5MG. 451C Chapter Road.
Three, five, five, eight.
3558.
About 20 quid.
landed.
Single or return.
What does single or return mean?
Do you want to go one way or do you want to come back?
I want to stay there when I get there.
For how long?
Until I go to university.
A single day, that'd be £17.
When is the train to London?
Platform 1, 5 minutes.
Where is platform 1?
Through the underpass up the stairs, you see the signs.
Underpass means tunnel, Christopher. In your head, imagine a big red line across the floor. Start at your feet and goes through the tunnel, and walk along the line. And count the rhythm in your head, because that helps, doesn't it? Like when you're doing your drumming, doing music. Left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left,
right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right.
Is this the train to London?
Christopher!
Come on, just in time, you've got your father at the police station. He's looking for you. Okay, let's not get overexcited here. Now look, I'm gonna take you back to the police station, and you, me, and your dad can have a little chat about who's going where.
Have you arrested him? Have you arrested father?
Arrested him? What for?
For killing Wellington. Wellington is a dog.
Well, I'm sure we can talk about that as well. But for right now, young man, I think you've done enough adventuring for one day. Now listen, you little monkey. You need to do something.
Bloody hell!
Why are you swearing? Have we started? Has the train started?
Don't move!
Rob, yeah, it's Nigel. I'm stuck here on the bloody train.
Yeah.
No, don't even. Look, it stops at Dick Cop Parkway, so if you can get someone to meet me with the car. Cheers. Tell us all now we've got him, but it's gonna take a while.
Okay.
Great. Well, let's have ourselves a seat. Park yourself. You're a bloody bad boy.
I notice everything. Most other people are lazy. They never look at everything. They do what is called glancing, which is the same word for bumping off of something and carrying on in almost the same direction. For example, if they are sitting on a train looking out of the window at the countryside, they might be noticing, one,
there are some cows in the field.
Two,
it's sunny with a few clouds.
Three,
there's flowers and grass.
Four,
there's a village in the distance.
And then they would stop noticing anything because they would be thinking of something else. Like,
I wonder if Julian's given birth yet.
Or,
I'm worried I might love the other one.
Or,
I really want a bag of cheesy Doritos.
But if I'm sitting looking out of the window of a train at the countryside, I notice everything. Like, one, there are 19 cows in the field, 15 of which are black and white, and 4 of which are brown and white. Two, there are 3 visible nimbostratus clouds. Three, there is a village in the distance which has 32 visible houses. There's a plastic bag in the hedge. Two, there is a swash Coca-Cola can with a snail on it. I can see 3, 4, 5, 6, 5 different types of grass. There is a... I can see 3, 4 different types of... there's a wind blowing from a... there's a Coca-Cola can, there's a snail, the snail, the snail, the cow, the cow, the cow, the cow's amazing!
Oh, don't you wet yourself! For God's sake, go to the bloody toilet, would you?
But I'm on a train!
They have toilets on trains, you know.
Where is the toilet on the train?
Through those doors there. But I'll be keeping an eye on you. Do you understand?
No.
Just go to the bloody toilet!
traps. They look like a train elf.
Well, we have both been drinking.
We should kidnap him.
He could be our elf mascot.
Come on, shift it, you stupid idiot. I waited for 9 more minutes, but no one else came by, and it was really quiet, and the train didn't move again, so I realized that the train had stopped. And I knew that the last stop on the train was London. So I got off the train.
Science fiction.
I'm worried about you.
You're lying.
haven't got any money.
I have. I saw your car.
You little...
And then you go up to the front gate and you put your ticket in the slot.
There's no Jubilee line. How are you going to get to Wilson Green?
There's a new line. I can take that to Wilson Junction.
Just come home.
Swindon is not my home anymore. My home is 451C Chapel Road, London, NW25NG.
Stand behind the yellow line.
I know.
It's going to be very noisy.
I know.
It'll really scare you.
I know.
Try not to let it. Watch the people. Watch how they get on and they get off. Count the trains. Figure out. Get the rhythm right. Train coming. Train stopped. Doors open. Train going. Silent. Train coming. Train stopped. Doors open. Train going. Silent. Train coming. Train stopped.
Doors open. Train going. Silent. Train coming. Train stopped. Doors open. Train going. Silent. Train coming. Train stopped. Doors open. Train going. Silent. Train coming. Train stopped. Doors open. Train going. Silent. Train coming. Train stopped. Doors open. Toby, where are you? Toby, you get back up here this instant. I'm warning you. Right, I'm coming down there to get you. And Toby, when I catch you, I am going to be very cross.
Oi, what are you doing?
My rat is on here.
Get out of there, for goodness sake!
Oh, my days! What is he doing?
What does that look like he's doing?
Well, of course, when he gets me, don't just stand there.
Mate, please get back up here.
Doors open. Is this train going to Wilson Junction?
There are 53,963 holiday quadrants. Scan the radio and
journey. Good to my
Is this train going to Wilson Junction?
3435.
Hesitate, you might have passed there. You failed to show a valid ticket for your entire journey.
Is this train going to Wilson Junction?
EPIC.
EPIC.
Not shutting the doors, can
tree. I'm sorry, okay?
Oh, well, perhaps you should have thought about that before you made me look like a complete idiot.
You weren't in, so I waited for you.
Christopher?
What?
Oh my God, Christopher!
What the hell is going on?
I'm so sorry, Christopher.
I suppose this means Ed's here.
Where's your father?
I think he's in Swindon.
Thank God for that.
Christopher, I didn't think I'd ever... Are you here on your own? Christopher, you're soaking wet. You don't just stand there.
You're going to come inside or you're going to stay out here, all right?
Father killed Wellington with a gun for
jumping jack.
Roger, please. Come on, Christopher, let's go inside and we do drive off.
Well, come on then, soldier. We're going to catch your death out here.
You follow, Roger.
He's hungry. Have you got any food I can give him? And some fresh water, too.
Are you okay, Christopher?
I'm tired.
I know, love. I can eat your blanket.
No, don't. I've got a sleeping bag in my backpack.
Will you let me help you get your clothes off? I can get you a clean t-shirt. You can get yourself into bed. T-shirt, pass me t-shirt.
I'm talking to her, whether you like it or not.
Stop.
I thought we'd spoken to you like that, in my own home. I'll talk to you however I like.
You have-
bloody use in writing to
you. Whoa, whoa, whoa!
Listen, I cooked his meals. I cleaned his clothes. I looked after him when he was ill. I took him to the doctor. I worried myself sick every time he'd wander off somewhere at night. I drove to the school every time he got into a fight. And you. Yes, you wrote him some bloody letters.
So you thought it was okay to tell my father I was dead?
Right now is not the time. I'm talking to him, and if you try and stop me...
Stay for a few days.
He can stay as long as he needs to stay.
There's hardly enough room for two of us, let alone three.
You can understand what you're saying, you know.
What's he gonna do all day? There's no school for him to go to. We both have jobs. It's bloody ridiculous.
Roger, that's enough. Christopher, you can stay as long as you want to stay.
It was Mother who gave me the milkshake. It was Mother who gave me the milkshake, not you. And you need to shout more loudly at him, like you're really angry with him, not just being nice.
Okay. Roger, that's enough! You can stay as long as you want to stay.
I have to go back to Swindon.
Christopher, you've only just got here.
I have to go back and sit my maths A-level.
You're doing maths A-level?
Yes, I'm taking it Wednesday and Thursday and Friday next week.
God, Christopher, that's really good.
Yeah. But I can't see Father, so I'll have to go back to Swindon with you.
I don't know whether that's going to be possible.
But I have to go.
Let's talk about this some other time, okay?
Okay. But I have to go back to Swindon.
Christopher, please!
Red dwarfs. And So, if you have difficult things in your life, it's nice to think that they are what is called negligible, which means they are so small that you don't have to take them into account when calculating something. I can't see any stars here.
No.
It's because of all the light pollution in London. All the lights from the street lights and the car headlights and the floodlights and the lights in the buildings get in the way of light from the stars by reflecting off the particles in the atmosphere.
Christopher! I have to go.
Don't!
Thank you.
time is it?
It's 4 o'clock in the morning.
What are you doing?
I'm packing some clothes.
Where is Mr. Shears?
He's asleep. Now come downstairs, bring Toby, and get into the car.
Into Mr. Shears' car?
That's right.
Are you stealing his car?
I'm just borrowing it, Christopher.
Where are we going?
We're going home.
Do you mean home in Swindon?
Yes.
Are we going back so I can sit my maths A level?
What?
I'm meant to be taking my A levels tomorrow.
We're going home because if we stay in London any longer, someone is going to get hurt. And I don't necessarily mean you. Now I need you to be quiet for a while.
How long do you need me to be quiet for?
Christopher, half an hour. I need you to be quiet for half an hour.
What are you doing here?
My house too, please be quiet.
And is your fancy man here as well?
That's really mature. So
you
talk
together and step your foot inside this house again. That you cannot.
This is not about me. This is not about you. This is about him. Everything I'm doing is for him.
Very.
How's your brain when you think about the maths?
That's very well.
Try this. What's the logarithmic formula for the approximate number of prime numbers not greater than x?
I can't think.
So, this is jolly exciting, eh, Christopher?
Well, I'm excited at least anyway.
Now, this exam is going to last for 2 hours, okay, Christopher? The first thing you're going to do is pop your name on the front.
All right, young man, you ready to roll? Turn over your paper, please, Christopher, and begin.
Scream. Christopher, I'm not going to hurt you. I just wanted to come and see how your maths exam went.
Tell them, Christopher. Please, Christopher.
I don't know if I got all the questions right because I was really tired because I hadn't slept at all and I hadn't eaten any food, so I couldn't think properly.
Thank you.
What for?
Just thank you. I'm very proud of you, Christopher. Very proud. I'm sure you did really, really well.
that. It's a room. It's very small. The corridor is painted brown. Other people use the toilet. Mother has to clean the toilet before I can use it. And the room smells like socks and pine air freshener. And sometimes there are other people in the toilet, so I do wet myself. And another bad thing is that Toby died because he was 2 years and 7 months old, which is very old for a rat. I don't like waiting for my maths A level result.
Yeah.
Mother doesn't get home from work until 5:30, so I have to stay at Father's house between 3:40 and 5:30. Mother said I didn't have a choice, and so I pushed the feather against the door in case Father tries to come into my room. And sometimes he tries to speak to me through the door. I don't answer him. And sometimes he sits outside my door quietly for a very long time. Can I come and live in your house so that I'll have room to put all my things and so that I won't have to share a toilet with strangers?
No, Christopher, you can't.
Why can't I? Is it because I'm noisy and sometimes difficult to control?
No. It's because I'm not your mother.
No.
That's very important. Do you understand that?
I don't know.
Christopher, can I have a talk with you?
No, 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 no. No, you can't. No.
It's okay, Christopher. I'm leaving.
I don't want to talk to Father.
I'll do you a deal. 5 minutes. Okay, that's all. Christopher, things can't go on like this. I don't know about you, but this hurts too much. Christopher, I need you to trust me. And I don't care how long it takes. It takes 1 minute today, 2 minutes the next, 3 the next. I don't care if it takes a whole year. Because this is important. This is the most important thing. Let's call it a project. A project we have to do together. Now I have to show you that you can trust me. It'll be difficult at first. Because it's a difficult project. But it'll get better. I promise. And I got your present. To show you that I mean what I say, and to say sorry. Well, you'll see what I mean.
Where is he going?
I don't know. I guess we'll just have to wait and see, won't you, Christopher?
I don't like waiting.
Trust me,
I definitely know.
He's 4 months old. Christopher, I would never do anything to hurt you.
You won't be able to take him with you, I'm afraid. The flat is too small. But your father's going to look after him here, and you can come and take him for walks whenever you want.
Does he have a name?
No. You can decide what to call him.
Sadly. He's called Sadly.
We have to go now, Christopher.
Yes, sir.
We will come back and see him tomorrow.
Okay. tomorrow.
Right.
angry. And this is what I wrote. Stop the clock. So, if a triangle is right angled, one of the angles will be 90 degrees and will therefore follow Pythagoras' theorem. Pythagoras said that a squared plus b squared equals c squared. To put it simply, if you draw a square around each side of the three sides of a right angled triangle, then add up the area of the two smaller squares, it will equal the area of the largest square. This is only true if your triangle is right angled. Come on, Mr. Wells! So, the max A level question is an algebraic formula for making right angled triangles. And n squared plus 1 is the biggest number in our equation, which makes it the hypotenuse, which is the longest side of the triangle. Now, we need to solve the area of all squares. To solve the area of a square, you multiply the length by the width. So, the area of this square is equal to 2n multiplied by 2n, which equals 4n squared. Now, we need to solve the area of this square, which is equal to n minus 1 multiplied by n squared minus 1, which equals n to the 4th power minus 2n squared plus 1. Now, if we add the two squares together, it will equal n to the 4th power plus 2n squared plus 1. Now, we need to solve the area of the largest square on the hypotenuse of the triangle, which is equal to n squared plus 1 multiplied by n squared plus 1, which equals n to the 4th power plus 2n squared plus 1, which is the same term! So, if you add up the area of the two smaller squares, it will equal the area of the largest square. Therefore, all my triangles fit together to satisfy Pythagoras' theorem, so the triangle is right angle!